I bring Siavish for not only introducing me to hypnosis, but also to, you know, have invited me here for me to share my experiences. I'm not primarily a hypnotist or a hypnotherapist. I'm, as such, I never had an interest. I thought, like somebody who was trained initially in psychoanalytical ways, that Freud had moved on. He started his studies in hysteria with Joseph Breuer by hypnotizing people. And so we read about it as something of historical interest. Pehle hypnosis karke to baad mein phir free association ki gayi. Pehle hypnosis mein logon se pucha jata tha ki aapke sath kya hua, traumatic events kya the, and so on. So it was of historical interest. Then more recently I attended some workshops on hypnotherapy, and but they were not the kind of workshops that Ibrahim Savish does. They were experienced hypnotherapists conducting hypnosis on us and leaving us with that. So I organized it as a co-facilitator at the GCU clinical psychology program. I invited a hypnotherapist, he conducted a very good workshop. In fact, that was the first time I went into a trance. And I got up from it and I realized what a powerful technique that was. And then I sought training. But I'm sorry, it wasn't available. Even when training was promised by somebody here, they said, okay, for the first 2 days, we'll introduce it even more. And then blah, blah, blah. So it was like a, you know, being in a goose chase. And then I happened to visit England several times since two of my older children live there. I'm a British citizen. I keep going there. And I said, well, this is the best place to get hypnotherapy training. And then I picked up, you know, the Psychologist, the magazine of the British Psychological Association, to which I'm a subscriber. And I was spoiled for too much choice. So there were at least 50 different advertisements of hypnotherapy workshops. And I asked my niece, who is a practicing psychologist in England, which one? She said, take your chance. And her, she could not even recommend any. And she said, one of these could be bogus, one of these could be good. They're all charging something like £1,000 for a day's training, and even that would be an introductory. So we don't know what's going on. So I come back and I discover that Ibrahim Savish is saying, I want to do this. I said, are you going to teach me how to put people in trance? That was my first question.
Yes.
And he said, yes. I was like, all right, you know, I'm all support for you. And so what I was astonished by was, he could have kept it as this,
yes,
you know, powerful trade secret, and would have minted millions, honestly. But he decided to open it up. So that was, I think, something very, very remarkable. Yes. We should applaud. The second thing that I want to share here with you is that it sparked my interest. I said, I want to read Freud's studies on hysteria when he actually used hypnosis. So he abandoned it later in the interest of free association. But what did he do? And I was astonished that it had, most of his work in hypnosis had nothing to do with the theory of sexuality that he came up with later. So for instance, he says that I hypnotized this client and she started to talk about a traumatic event. And he said that she never mentioned this traumatic event either before hypnosis or even after hypnosis. So I managed to erase any memory of that traumatic event during hypnosis, which is just like how NLP or hypnotherapists are working today. And I read through these case studies and it was fascinating. I would strongly recommend that people go back to Breuer and Freud's studies on hysteria, his first published work on hysteria and how, which was basically conversion neurosis. So that was the first thing. then my own experiments with hypnotherapy, because I'm an experienced therapist, and I said, look, I'm going to be using hypnosis, is it okay? You know, he was very, very supportive of that. He said, okay, share with me also what you find. So I decided to, you know, use this, and I found that there was a one session cure for asthma. One session cure. There was a one session cure for chronic depression and a knee problem. I'm not saying that it's successful in every case. There was, you know, I would also mention some failures, which is very important, but also some new techniques that I was discovering along the way. So I adapted. Some people are very religious. So even though Ibrahim is very firm on this, ki religion ko mix nahi karna, people who had very strong belief systems that were religious, I used religious imagery for them. It worked very well. Then I encountered resistance. So one person comes in, sits through the whole thing, and then opens their eyes. ये क्या? आप बोलते रहे, मैं सुनते रहे, मुझे तो कुछ नहीं पता चला, मैं सोई तो नहीं. मैं क्या, हमने सुना है, था भी नहीं. नहीं नहीं, मगर ये क्या? You just told me a lot of things. So that made me think, people are different. You know, I have always believed that everybody is different, and people are going to react differently to different things. So here was this person who was probably too anxious. She's reported herself as being too anxious. She needed to relax. And I, in my self-confidence, just assumed that oh, you were hypnotized. She wasn't hypnotized. And that brought me back to Milton Erickson. I remember Ibrahim, when introducing hypnotherapy, said, well, this is one of the biggest names in modern hypnotherapy. And Milton Erickson does not give direct suggestions. So while I totally understand Ibrahim's method of teaching, that we have to start with direct suggestions. We have to be in a position of power. And we have to have that confidence, because that will help the client settle down. But then we must move on to other things, like indirect suggestions. So for instance, Milton Erickson would say, some people will close their eyes when they reach 5, some people like 10, some might do so at 15. अपने कोई जिम्मेदारी नहीं है, 20 पे भी बेशक खुली रखो, ठीक है? अब आप 20 पे पहुंच गए हैं, right? And then you can say, and now if you really would like to relax, some people will go into deep trance. So, you know, I was reading about that and thought, okay, वो 25 को चाहे गिनती पे चला जाए, 50 पे चला जाए, आपकी जिम्मेदारी नहीं, because you're saying some people. दूसरी thing he said is कि अगर आपको शक है कि वो ट्रांस में है या नहीं है या नहीं जा रहा, तो आप कहें, if you are in a trance, you could tell me by raising your right hand very slowly, and if you are not in a trance, you could lift your left hand very slowly as if you were in a trance. Beautiful. अब या राइट उठाएगा या लेफ्ट उठाएगा, और लेफ्ट भी उठाएगा तो ऐसे उठाएगा जैसे कि ट्रांस में है. एंड द नेक्स्ट थिंग ही डज इज ही टेक्स द ट्रांस, इवन इफ द पर्सन इज सेइंग कि लेफ्ट हैंड उठा. सो ब्यूटिफुल एंड एंडलेस एरे ऑफ क्रिएटिविटी इज पॉसिबल इफ यू आर इनटू हेल्पिंग द क्लाइंट. ये याद रखें, अल्टीमेटली इट इज नॉट अबाउट अस. Ultimately, it is not about, लेकिन we don't want to be embarrassed in hypnosis. लेकिन ना therapist के पास जब आता है तो आप ये तो नहीं कहते कि मैं भी, मुझे भी कल anxiety attack हुआ भी हो. You don't share these kinds of things because इसलिए नहीं कि आपकी कोई बेइज्जती हो जाए, इसलिए कि client आप पे trust नहीं. So client के फायदे में है कि you are seen as somebody with authority. It is very important. And that is why direct suggestions are a very good place to start. Well, then we must move on to other possible techniques also, such as indirect suggestions. Some people, most people feel, most people ke bada mazay ka pressure hota hai. If most people do it, I must, therefore. I don't want to be abnormal. I don't want to be most people by the before, well before the count of 20. Another thing I do is I start with 5 and 10 and I stop there. But we will count to 20, but somewhere maybe at 5 and maybe at 10 you will fall. 15 ka number mein dalte ho kyunki wo fir bahut aage hai aur jo banda 15 tak ja raha hai fir wo aapko mehsoos hona shuru ho jata. So that's another thing you can tweak with. Acha, the other thing that I found really fascinating, because that's something that Freud did, and a lot of it was patients talking, clients talking, whereas we are the ones talking in this. So it was scary at the beginning to allow that to happen, but then I conducted full sessions once the client was in hypnosis to just make them talk. So NLP techniques, like you mentioned, I'm sure you guys also witnessed some of it in your workshops, was something like, okay, so remember your happiest memory. So, or something that comes to mind is a happy memory. Now remember another happy memory. Now compare these two. Which one is happier? And first I was getting answers by raising your right hand, raising your left hand, raising your index finger. So it creates a hypnotic environment when somebody is not talking. But then I said, okay, tell me about this memory. That they and then they talk about it. And usse pehle jo ek reassurance aap create kar sakte hain ki you will tell me all about it while remaining in trance. Taki wo banda ye na samjhe ki use ijazat di ja rahi hai to come out. So, and then I tried age regression, which was another amazing experience. Put a whiteboard in the session next to the client, told them to sign their signatures as they do, right? So they signed it, and then they said, when I said, took them back, I said, you are 5 years old now, right? I could see the person's facial expressions changing, like, and then said, please write your name on the board. The person wrote their name in block letters. When I emerged them from hypnosis, told them to look at the board, said, this is how you sign your name. And they were really astonished. So, you know, so you can do all sorts of things, but it's very important to practice ethically. It is very important never to do something that you feel might harm the client. That is why I tested first on my son. I put the video on YouTube so that my clients know I consider it fairly safe. I was hypnotized. I was among the first to volunteer to be hypnotized in the workshop. I did it on my son, my wife, to reassure that this is a safe thing, and if something that I could subject my own family to, I would only then subject my clients to. I can go on talking, I love to talk, I'm a teacher, but I know that we are here for an important purpose. I would just say that practice responsibly, but also commit yourself to learning. And especially I would say that, you know, at some point I would like Ibrahim to conduct workshops on hypnotherapy and, you know, talk more about healing people. Taking away the pain, taking away the suffering, then also maybe talking about how to make people talk during hypnosis, how to have them talk about painful experiences, how to deal with ab reaction, because that's something that even Freud was concerned about during hypnosis. So with these words, I'd like to once again congratulate all of you for having accomplished a major milestone in your career. Even at this late stage of my therapy career, I consider it a very, very huge milestone. And I think that it has radically altered my practice. And so once again, congratulations and good luck. Thank you, Ibrahim.